Howdy, howdy, boys and girls. Welcome back to Paper Mario and the Thousand Year Door. We just got into Hooktail's Castle. I don't remember which way to go first. We're going this way. I'm pretty sure it's this way. Goomba. Just immediately go for the Goomba. They're weak. I missed. I'm weak. Yeah, let's take out this first. So, yeah, I did my FP last time I leveled up, so I shouldn't have to do that for a while. And we also just got Koops, and I am apparently extremely rusty. I usually don't miss two action commands in the same fight. Don't need that anyway. There we go. Now, I'm not gonna lie, most of these enemies at the beginning I'm gonna have to tattle a lot, because I'm much more used to the end game enemies than I'm used to the beginning enemies. So honestly, yeah, a lot of these are a lot easier. That doesn't mean necessarily I'll understand how to beat them. Almost every enemy has like a gimmick. Ah! And yes, there are some enemies that are just ridiculously strong, and that is their gimmick. But because they're so few and far between, might as well just overpower everything. Alright, this one set on a timer. So we'll throw Koops out, hit it, running. Yeah. And this should look familiar.
What the heck? Hey, guess. It's been a long time since anyone came here. A real long time. Huh? You heard me? Wow! Wait a sec. If you can hear my voice, you must be some legendary hero or something.
Seem familiar?
Or not. To be honest, I'm sure anyone with ears can hear me. But it sure is fun singing people with that whole legendary hero bit. Hey, but seriously, folks. I was wondering if you could let me out of this chest? I've been locked in here so long I'm starting to get cramped up like you wouldn't believe. All you have to do is find the key and let me out. Easy. Huh? What? What do you mean? You think you'll be cursed if you open the box? Ridiculous. Who would do that, really? Wait, a box and curse, folks. Real slime ball, that's who. But I'm not a real slime ball, and I would do no such thing, but that should be obvious. Look, if you help me out, maybe I'll help you out. You know, little, I scratch your back, you scratch mine, except in reversed order. Of course, you don't have to if you really don't want to. Like, finding a key is hard.
And as always, actually, I think there's... Yeah, there's a crack in that wall, but I can't do anything about it. Got a black key. Oh, wow. It was trapped.
Mario, look at that.
Got spikes coming from the ceiling.
I don't look like the look of this. Come on, run.
No, I don't remember which way to go, but I'm pretty sure this is the wrong way. It might not be. Never mind. It was the right way. And yeah, they give you, what, 40 seconds was that to do this? Do it in 5?
Man, that was too close.
Totally, I had 35 seconds to still get out of there.
Alright, buddy, get out of there. Weehee, fools.
I think that was up the whole time.
Why only the most idiotic pudding brain dolt would fall for a scheme like that. The castle's traps prevent anyone from entering this place from ever leaving it. No matter which path you take, you're fated to waste away to a slow, painful death. But wait, there's more to this great deal. I'll throw in a free curse, no charge. Oogly googly boo.
Weehee, now you're cursed, doofus, and if it serves you right, this curse is more cursedly curse-worthy than any curse that's ever cursed you.
Tongue twister much? Vroor, this curse makes you like a piece of paper when you press the hold R button.
Weehee, what a curse. Who curses like me? No one.
Now I shall show you just how frightful a curse it is. Go on, press and hold R. Press and hold R now, yeah. It's very simple.
Weehee, just look at yourself. How embarrassing for you. Eat a sandwich, skinny. Hit. Do you understand what this curse means for you?
Yes.
Then farewell, you dumbbells.
It's kind of funny because you actually see some characters, like, especially your partners, whenever you switch out partners, they kind of morph into like the paper forms themselves. So it kind of makes you wonder, like, does everyone go through that?
You got the attack FXR, change the sound effects of Mario's attacks.
Now some badges, which are usually basically useless, require no BP. But, makes my hammer sound like a cricket. Or my jumps, but that just doesn't work in the overworld. It's basically whenever I hit an enemy, it'll sound like a cricket now. So useful, right? I'll go over here. Like a built-in elevator. That door's locked, so let's go this way. Can't go this way. So we have to find a key. Right near the entrance. Do you remember that key we saw in the grate? We gotta go there now. I just realized my frame rates drop like when I go through a door, but because it's all dark, you can't see it. Why is he still following me? The other guy gave up. There you go. I could do my hammer, but it's more guaranteed if I just do that because I don't have to do anything. Bah. Now, just think about it. This is the first world of, what was it, 7 crystal stars? Ow. And you already see how, like, massive and honestly awesome looking this first world is. A 69 star points. Just kind of put that out there. But no, this is just the first world and it's already an entire castle, like, massive. There it is, there's the key. Massive with, like, cool story elements and all this stuff. It doesn't slack off later on. Like, it stays this energy the entire game. This is why I consider this one of the best story building, world building games out there. Because even I don't really like world building too much in games, because usually they go either too far or they make no sense. But this one just kind of gets to the point while still being, like, stressful and intriguing and all this. So I really like this game for that story element, and they take it up another notch in the Super Paper Mario for the Wii. Like, the story is unheard of, but then they lose the... This is also always cool, this effect. But they lose the amazing, the combat. Like, it's not as thorough, it's not as interesting. The puzzles are still... Actually, the puzzles are a little harder slash a little better in the next game. But the combat is just ruined. Like, gutted to believe. Like, more than you could believe. It's just horrible. And I still like the game. I just can't get over that. And I probably never will. There we go. Because I could never bring myself to finish it because I was so disappointed in how the combat is. Like, it's only an overworld combat. There is no turn-based anything like this one. So that's where I'm really hoping Origami King, the newest Paper Mario that's coming out for the Switch, really fixes that, honestly. I lost my magic number of star points, but oh well. And if it doesn't, I honestly just might not buy it. And I am a very avid Paper Mario fan, so as you can tell, that's saying something. And looks like there's something on that platform, so we're gonna kill you, because you're almost definitely an enemy.
Who's throwing what? Oh, it's a mushroom. That's what that noise is. It'll give you that noise as kind of a caution whenever someone's about to throw something at you. But if it's an item, you can take it. I'm pretty sure I explained that already, making sure people are up to date. I won't explain this stuff later, so keep that in mind. Ugh. I also went swimming for the first time this summer, just yesterday, because it was the 4th of July. I went out with my cousins and stuff. This item's really good. Life Shroom. It's basically like an instant revive if you're out and about. Let's see, how much time has it been? It's been 10 minutes. I'm an idiot. I'm sorry. Look away for a second and I can't see the game. And Hooktail has to be one of my favorite bosses because he's got so much, like, he's got so much attitude about him. Hey! Huh? Oh my, who's this handsome piece of cheese? I can't believe there are other thieves here besides me. How very strange. Hey! Who are you? Me? Why, I'm Miss Mouse, the globe-trotting thief. Heard of me, sweetie? I heard there were wearing valuable badges here in this castle. That's why I'm here. But the real question is, why are people like you roaming in such a rundown place? Well, you see, we're here to beat Hooktail and get the, Crystal Star. So, don't think we'll let you get the Crystal Star first, no matter how cute you are. Crystal Star, you say? Mm-hmm. I didn't know a thing like that was hidden in this castle. Sounds intriguing. Perhaps I just heard something you didn't want me hearing? Mm-hmm. Darn! Coops, you're an idiot. Oh, but that's okay. I mean, you were looking for this Crystal Star first, and I already found the badge I was after, so I'll let you get your Crystal Star. hey, what's that supposed to mean? I mean, it means I must say goodbye for now, Mr. Cutie. I know it's sad, we just met you already, it is time to say farewell. Oh my, you're so bold. Is that legal? No, it is not legal. Let's point that out right now. I don't care if she is a woman. If the roles were reversed, it is illegal. Oh, I almost forgot. I have a little secret to share with you. Somewhere in this castle is a badge that'll help you best Hooktail. Or so I've heard. I don't know what kind of badge it is. Maybe you found it already, maybe not. If you're going to fight Hooktail, I'd recommend finding that badge first. Well, take care, handsome mustache man. Let's get together again real soon. I wonder what her story is. I bet it's an interesting one, full of romance. Nerd. Alright, what's in this one? Mushroom, don't need that. Key, I need that. And honey syrup, pretty interesting. Shine sprites. Okay, a lot of things happens right there. So Miss Mouse is interesting, because whenever you see her, a badge appears in a shop that is usually pretty good. So the assumption there is kind of she steals it from here and sells it to that shop. And I'll have to show you guys that shop later to get it. But she also mentioned a badge to help you fight Hooktail, and earlier on the dead dry bones thing with the blue coat, it said that Hooktail was weak to some kind of noise that was with a horrible little, I don't know, puzzle, I don't know what to call it, riddle, something like that. It's a cricket. Hooktail doesn't like listening to crickets. You got a badge that makes you sound like a cricket. You can make the connection. So yes, we already found it. Okay, let's jump on this guy. I kind of don't want to get hit, so we're just gonna power shell. So yeah, it would have been really cool to have a badge there, but we got to meet Miss Mouse, so that's good. 86 star points, we're about to level up. Ooh. I have too many items, you do have limited item space, that does get bigger later. I don't really go to inns, so I usually just toss the inn coupons, but spite pouches are literally so horrible that I don't want them. At least this early. Spite pouches are better later on in the game, I'm not just gonna save it forever though.
Alright, looks like I'm gonna have to use FP again. But see, like, especially how they think of every individual battle as special. Like, just for example, like, the only way to deal with that Dry Bones at this stage in the game is to use Koops' Shell Toss or the hammer to get to him. So you put a Koopa in front of him, and he's basically invincible. Of course, if you use FP, this fight becomes very, easy. But there is still a way to do it. So every single fight is like its own puzzle, and there's thousands of fights in this entire game. You can redo fights by like letting enemies respawn and all that. I can't grab that. Make sure you're dead. Yes. Okay. You're not dead, though. Okay. There's no way I can prevent myself from taking damage this turn, so I'll just do all that I can. Without wasting any FP. Took 2 damage. But that's all I will take. Oh, and this should level me up, I just realized. Awesome. There we go. And he's dead. Alright, so. Now we can equip the multi-bounce again. But after this, I won't have any extra badges to equip, so. Trying to think of any other places I know of. Oh, didn't mean to hit that twice. Okay, so is there anything over here? No, there's a star piece on the other side, though. Anything over here, though? No. And there's that airplane platform again. Because these are so narrow. Falling off these suck, because you actually go really, it could take a while, because I've done it many times where I'd do it once, I'd fall off, I'd get frustrated, and then I'd goof up again and fall off. Becomes one of those real quick. Okay, so. Yeah, okay. This is kind of forcing me to backtrack a little bit if I want this, but there's a badge down here I know of that I have to get. Okay, yeah. Last stand. Last stands are actually really good. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Yeah. Drop the damage your ally takes by half when in danger. So at 5 health, Koops will now take half damage. Basically just means Koops can survive another turn. Probably cut out most of this. Alright, now we're back up here. Let's go up instead. So we got that key, so there's probably gonna be a locked door up ahead. And a shine sprite. I think we're close to the top, too. I saw that. Alright, let's kill that first. Ah, okay, I forgot that happens. I would have been a little more concerned about stopping that. But now Koops is useless because he's on his back. Yeah, though Koops is really strong, he does that have that one disadvantage. Same as every other Koopas. Why can I never time that? I just need him out of here. I don't know why, they're one of the easiest enemies in the game, but the Spike Goombas, I always can't time that. Why am I messing up so much now? Maybe I should just give up on pressing B on attacks. I mean, I do have a mushroom if it gets too bad, but they're all dead, so. See, I only got 5 star points for all of those. Getting to the point where I'm over-leveled for this situation. Oh, God. Like how the music changes the wind, though. Right, so that's on the ground. That's on the ground. Yeah, okay. I just need to block with Koops when they attack him, because I can't afford to have him on his back. Nope, get back down. I don't like fighting Koopas, especially at the beginning of the game. Just because of how long it takes to fight him. If you want to do it smart. But I can't hit you back. But because I'm actually fighting every enemy, Hooktail should be roughly... I'll walk in the park. Should just be one more enemy and then it's Hooktail. Went up the tower, up the tower, up the tower. See that big open area up there? I can't see him. Oh, I don't think he can go past there. Oh, yes, yes he can. Darn it. Here, I'm just gonna use FP now, because we're always... This is the last enemy. There we go. That was what's supposed to happen. One. Now with this game, it's also got great spacing. So, one, technically you weren't supposed to do what I did with the red bones. So I got a good amount of extra SP that I shouldn't have gotten. Heal up here real quick. Yes, I know what it does. Then we're gonna save here. But, I should have gotten a lot of star points for the red bones, because that's what many bosses are made for. But I shouldn't have got as much as I did, if we're being completely honest. So looking at my star points, I probably got roughly 15 star points extra. Or no, what would it be? Because there was 3 dry bones and a red bones, and I made him spawn like 4 or 5 more dry bones or something. So yeah, I don't think I should have leveled up that last time. So, because it would be more than 15 at that point. If it was 5, I think they gave 4 at that point. I think I took 20 extra out of them. So I believe I am higher level than I should be. So I just have to go on this and take care of this guy. But anyway, yeah, they're supposed to be very set out distances between everything, so that you enter boss fights where it's still difficult, but not impossible. Who dares approach me? And this is the first boss. You fight a dragon. Kind of saw this coming, obviously, but...
So, you are friends of the strange garbed one who came earlier. I didn't expect more to come to steal the treasure I protect. Such rashness. That was foolish, I fear. Do you really think you can beat me? But you're so small, and you don't appear tasty. I suppose you might make a good snack. And the bottoms of your feet smell like they might make a good sauce with some spices. What I'll do is I'll saute you to crispy goodness and gobble you down head first.
There we go.
Snack time, little appetizers. But which one of you morsels shall I taste first?
Can't flee this fight. Okay, so we'll switch here. Bring Kumbella out so she can tattle next turn, and I want him dead as soon as possible, so.
Blech, that awful sound. Sounds like a cricket. How did you know? Stop that this instant. I got really bad food poisoning once when I ate a cricket. I hate them.
Why would you eat a cricket? You're the size of like a house.
Oh, fight it, Hooky. Just hearing cricket chirp makes me feel woozy.
Now, if you notice, ow, my power smash does 4 damage, but it only did 3 damage on him. So I know he has 1 defense, and he just did 3 damage to us, so he's probably got roughly 3 attack. Max HP is 20, attack is 5, defense is 1. It'll stomp and munch on you and add some more dragonish attack, stinky and fiery breath. It's tricky, especially when it's losing, and it'll try to fool you into being merciful. Oh yeah, one more thing. It hates things that start with cur and end with igget. Supposedly there's something related to that somewhere in the castle. Did we find it? Yes, and it's already equipped. Okay, so now we see his stats. But the cool thing is, when I hit it with the power smash, it did 3 damage instead of 4. So I know he had defense of 1. But the stage falling, which only has an attack of 1, still did 1 damage. So me attacking him and causing the cricket sound made him weak. So now I know he doesn't have any defense. So if I do power smash again, it's 4 again.
Must not gag my poor tummy. Oh, so very woozy.
And it's just kind of fun to sit here and torment this big old dragon now that you know he's weak. Alright, yeah, see. Now that I've let Goombella get hit a bunch, Koops can come back out. Do another power smash. Ow, someone dropped a bucket on him. Seems his attack went down again. So now I know he only has 2 attack. So I can just guard with Koops and he'll be fine. So yeah, if you fully like set up and think through your fights and not mess up like I just did, you're basically guaranteed to win these fights. But you don't always know what you need as much as it tells you in this first world. I won't be so bad anymore, I promise. In fact, I'm sorry for everything. Yeah. To prove it, I'll give you 1,000 coins. What do you say? Can you forgive me? Keep your coins, fiend. What? You must be joking. You don't need any coins? And how about the lovely, rare, extra special badge I have? I'll give you that. It's one of a kind. It's yours for a limited time only. Will you take it? Now, I will say right now, if he was not lying, I'd actually want this. Because the badges in this game get ridiculous. So this would be so cool if you could, like, find out some way to actually get a badge out of him. If you agree to any of this, though, he'll literally walk up to you like, oh, here, let me give it to you, and then eat you. And it doesn't, like, bite, gad, chomp, and, like, eat you. He'll literally just bite you and Mario dies. It's not even a fun little animation. Really? Well, I suppose I could apologize by letting you smell the bottoms of my feet. People pay good money to do this. I'm being completely honest right now, really. So, care to take a whiff of the rich yet delicate scent of my world-renowned feet? That's disgusting. You aren't a very trusting fellow, are you? It's important to be able to trust someone, you know. Or, I guess I'd better... But look at all the toads. He ate them. He ate the toads. Now my strength has returned to me! I've had enough of this. Let's finish this guy off fast, Mario. Yeah, you got 10 health back. That's literally nothing, because I can still... If he doesn't kill me this turn, I can beat him easily. Oh, also, if you hit him in the mouth, the toads come back out. Just a cool little thing to notice. It would have been really cool if I got all my FP back. Yeah, see? All the toads come back out. But how? Why? There's still so much I wanted to do with my life. So many meals! Dead. But that was so cool back when I was a kid. How a boss actually came out of, like, the arena. Like, this is the first time I'd seen a game actually use this stage mechanic where, like, oh, the fighting happens on the stage, and it immediately breaks that rule by they all jump off stage, start fighting in the crowd. All we have to do is find that crystal star thing you're looking for, Mario.
You gonna puke.
Everybody hide.
I'm out. I'm finally out.
Whoa, it can't be.
Eh?
Dad? Hey, you're Koopsh.
Hey, son, you've gotten so big since I saw you last.
Well, yeah, I guess I have, but who cares, Dad? I mean, golly, what happened to you? Where have you been all this time?
Well, I came here a while back to deal with Hooktail, and all was well and good. But just before my finishing blow, he played a trick on me and gobbled me down whole. I've been hiding in my shell for the 10 years since then, inside Cooktail's belly. And boy, was it nasty, ugh. I'm so glad I finally got out. Honestly, Dad,
don't you know how worried about you we all were? For 10 long years, we all thought we thought your game was over.
Oh, sorry, son, but I'm okay. That's good, right? We're together now, right? Hey, speaking of which, what are you doing here, anyway?
Oh, come on, Dad. I came here to defeat Hooktail, who's been wreaking havoc in town. Mr. Mario here is looking for a gem called the Crystal Star.
Crystal Star? This wouldn't be what you're talking about, would it?
It is, yes.
What's that?
Found it down there in Hooktail's belly. Nice, huh? I kept it as a souvenir. So, this is the thing you're looking for. Perfect, just perfect. You can have it.
Free gem. Take it, Mario. Take it and run. Looks expensive. Sell it.
Hooktail twitched. I saw Hooktail twitch.
Earth Tremor.
It's actually really useful for the entire rest of the game. End of chapter.
Mario and friends finally got a crystal star in the castle after defeating Hooktail. Koops even reunited with his long-lost father, whom he thought was dead. Yet they were unable to learn anything about the whereabouts of the princess. Where could Princess Peach be? Yes, Mario's adventure has only just begun. That was chapter one. Chapter one, world one, whatever you want to call it. We ain't nearly done. Another cool thing this game does, though, you get little side stories in between each chapter. There's X-Nauts. Now we know where Peach is. Where someone's buying through a camera right now. Oh, great exalted Grotus. We brought the Princess Peach you ordered, sir. Like a pizza. You ordered this, right? Well, 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 my pets. Isn't it about time you told us where the map is? Princess Peach, you will speak when spoken to.
I'm telling you, I don't know.
There's no point in trying to hide it, silly girl. We know you had it. We know this. Trust me, it's very much in your interest to be absolutely honest with us. We X-Nauts are not all rainbows and lollipops, I assure you. We're quite nasty.
Grotus, sir, I have news. Report at once. You know that crystal star we thought maybe Hooktail had? Well, someone nabbed it.
What did you say? Someone else is after the crystal stars? And he defeated that Hooktail creature, you say? Speak, soldier.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. There's more, too. See, according to the report, it was a mustache dude in a red hat and blue overalls who pulled the job.
Mario!
Yeah, excuse me? You should maybe shut up, not get me caught. I see. So you know of this Mario, do you? This fool matters not at all. I'll know all about him before long. That I promise. I grow bored of talking. Take Princess Peach back to her the holding room.
Yes, sir.
And men, take good care of Princess Peach. Understand? She is not to be harmed.
You got it, sir.
So they ain't gonna torture her, at least. That's good. Well, Lord Crumb, if this Mario character has the map, then it's highly likely that you'll find the crystal star we're hunting in Boggly Woods. You must return there immediately and hasten the excavation. It must not fail.
Was that? Oh, yeah, sir. Sure. Sorry, Grotus. And with that, pow, I'm gone.
It's like a big child. I wonder if sending Lord Crump there alone is wise. He's a bit out there. X-Nauts, I summon you. I summon X-Nauts.
You rang, dude. I mean, sir. You rang, Sir Grotus, dude. Grotus. Sir Grotus, sir.
Shut up. Go get the Shadow Sirens over here.
The Shadow Sirens, sir? But they...
I don't care how you plan to end that sentence, fool. Go get them. Now.
Gotcha.
I like that kind of character. The Honorable Grotus has need of us, and we arrived without delay.
Very different characters. Meehee. Pray tell, did the princess tell you where the map is?
Still your tongue, Beldum. We would already have it if you'd snatched her earlier. But now since you missed your chance, some poor fool named Mario has the map.
It wasn't my fault, truly. There were too many prying eyes there. Too many.
Besides, a strange old man showed up at the moment of truth, and we had to retreat. Why worry?
All we need to do now is find this Mario and steal the map, yes?
Indeed, that is your duty, must I remind you? That map is vital to the X-Nauts plan. I will have my men prepare all available information on this Mario. For now, hear me, Beldum. You Shadow Sirens must take care of this troublemaker.
Weehee, fear not, sire. I, Beldum, shall return with what you seek. Let's go, my lovelies. Marilyn, Vivian, come. We've got a job to do.
Why does Vivian look normal? Space. Random room. Peach.
Oh dear, here we go again. I can't believe I'm kidnapped again. Mario and Toadsworth must be worried sick. Again. But hang on a moment. Where in the world am I anyway? It's so unfamiliar. I wish I could at least let Mario and Toadsworth know that I've been caught.
And she's not exactly a total idiot in this game, which is great. She understands that it's horrible that sheep's getting kidnapped and she shouldn't let this happen.
Go to the bathroom. Take a bath? What a lovely shower. No soap scum even. Wow, I wonder if it works. Oh. We shouldn't be seeing this. Close your eyes.
Hurt.
Close your eyes.
I didn't see anything if you didn't.
How refreshing. I feel like a new princess.
This is adorable. I don't know if there's like no game like where you see her in a ponytail, but that is the best looking thing ever. And then it goes back to this.
Ooh, a door open. What was that? Hey, how odd. The doors open by themselves.
You have to admit, that was a little cute. Had her little hair up. Weird, it doesn't look like anyone's around.
Walk all the way across the hall. Oh. How do I keep making these doors open? How odd.
Looks like I should not be here.
Hello, Princess Peach. Huh, what? Who said that? Where are you? How amusing. I am right here before your eyes. I am this laboratory's main computer. I am Tech XX. You may call me Tex. Many call me Tex, you may. That's what it was. Sir Grotus created me to be the perfect computer, one with, that is flawless in its reason. Grotus, wait, he's that awful dome-headed thing who interrogated me, right? I can't speak. You know what? You know this by now. I basically have a speech impediment at this point, let's be fair. I get it from my mother. Sir Grotus is not awful. He is a very great person. He is marvelous. Well, I don't think so. But I doubt I'll change your mind. So I'm wondering, why did you leave me in here? I am unsure. An unusual program deviation occurred when I observed you earlier. My higher brain circuitry malfunctioned and nearly overheated at your image. Also, an unidentified impulse sped through my processors. These events are new to me. There is more to this phenomenon as well. I ran diagnostic programs, and their solution was, I want to know more about you. I want to observe you. Such a compulsion has no precedence. Cause unknown. I, the perfect computer. I must diagnose this unusual situation. I will not fail. That is why I led you here. Wait, did you just say, you want to observe me? To know more about me? For some reason, she makes this assumption. Could it be that you... No, impossible. It can't be. You're a computer. It's this scenario. Everyone understands this scenario. I kind of hate the Peach aspects of this game because it plays the heck out of this scenario. It's just too weird.
It is. It really is weird, and it's uncomfortable to watch, so we're just gonna... I am the world's best computer. I am perfect. I am perfect, Cell. There should not be anything that I do not understand. Please. Well, you know, maybe it's possible that, well, you're in love with me. Love? What is love? I cannot compute this. Wait, you don't know what love is? To be fair, this game came out, like, near the beginning of the GameCube. So it was still when this whole precedence was relatively new. So I guess it was probably interesting at some point. But, like, back when I played this game, I was so young. And now it's so overused, I'm just kind of like... I shouldn't joke about it too much. Some people might actually be interested in this. My programming is insufficient. There should be nothing I cannot comprehend. I am a perfect computer. Comprehend love? Love's not something you comprehend, Tech. You feel it. Princess Peach, will you teach me to feel this thing you call love? What? You're a computer. Why would you care about love? I am perfect. There must be nothing that I cannot comprehend. Nothing. That is why you must help me understand this thing called love. Please. If you have any wishes that I can grant you in exchange, I will grant them. But of course, I am unable to grant such a wish as letting you escape. What? Are you insane? You extras kidnapped me like common Koopas. Now you call me in here and ask me to teach you the meaning of love? I should spit on your screen. You'll grant my wishes? Ha! Why would I believe you?
I understand you are angry. That emotion I comprehend. You do not teach me. You need not teach me now. Stop yelling. But I must learn of this thing. I must. There is no alternative. I must be a perfect computer. That is why, if you would just consider teaching me, I will grant your wishes. Do you understand me, Princess Peach? Now, tell me your wish. Are you sure? Well, okay, here goes. Can I contact someone? The sooner the better. Yes, of course you may. Use my communicator to send wireless mail to anywhere you want. If you so wish, you can use it right now. It is no trouble. Use the keyboard in front of you. Enter recipient address and message.
You mean this keyboard? The only keyboard in the entire room? This keyboard?
That looks actually a lot like an actual keyboard. I don't know why I didn't. I thought it would be some weird kind of keyboard. I don't know. Between it being in the Mushroom Kingdom kind of a vibe and... Actually, no, it's not. What the heck? Did you guys see that?
Okay, then. Good night. See if it shows it again.
Good night, Princess Peach. Oh, it had, like, the main, like, left component of the keyboard were all the keys, and then it had a space, and then, like, where the arrows would go, there was buttons all the way to the top, because it's usually, like, let's do this. Shut up, it's dirty. Like, it's got the directional buttons and space here. It didn't have that space. It was just buttons all the way to the top. I don't know why that freaked me out for a second. I was like, Peach was covering it, so I was like, oh, it is a normal keyboard. Wait. Oh, but where's this? My favorite character in this game. My favorite character in any Mario game, really. Bowser the mighty Koopa King has arrived. Hold your applause, minions. But now that I'm here, Cammy, you old crusty old hag. Why did you summon me?
Great Lord Bowser, the crusty hag Cammy Koopa will arrive momentarily. I'm really sorry for the inconvenience, but please wait at the rear of the room.
You get to control Bowser in this game. It's so great. I love it. I love it. You get to do that in the Wii one too, but like, you do it more in that one, so it's better, if anything.
So the other day, I saw Lord Bowser gazing longingly at a photo of Princess Peach.
You might want to put a cork in it, man. Ooh, I tell you, the look on his face when he was mooning over that thing. Huh?
Ah! Lord Bowser!
Well, I'm dying to hear the rest of your hilarious story, Mr. Comedian. Do share.
I'm not funny, sir. He's not funny, sir.
Lord Bowser, I have been training day and night to help you conquer the world. Should the time come, I shall be ready. Order me as you please, your surliness.
Super. In that case, order you to do some sit-ups, Toby.
You have no right to say that.
But that's part of your character. It's so great.
Right at the end of the hall. And wait. Portrait.
How do they get candles to have blue flames? Like, how hot does a candle have to get? Well, I mean, it's still just as hot as any other flames, but how can you get a candle that hot that has blue flames?
I have just now returned. I'm terribly sorry,
Terribly sorry to keep you waiting, my lord.
I bet you are, Cammy. Now get out with it. Why have you called me here?
Please, your grumpiness, don't be so impatient with your poor servant.
Ahem. It's my displeasure to report that Mario, that scum, is off to a town called Rogueport.
Pfft. Now, my Mario's babysitter. I don't care what he's doing. Are you gonna call me every time that guy blows his nose or what? Sheesh.
Yes, well, you see, my lord, apparently Mario is hunting for an amazing treasure.
Treasure?
Yes, Mario has gone in search of star-shaped jewels known as the Crystal Stars. I'm researching just what they are, but there's no question of their high value.
The Crystal Stars, you say? They sound like a good world-conquering tool. I want them. So easy to, like, manipulate. Yes, very good. Continue researching this for me, you brainy hag, you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Leave it to me.
By the way, Lord Bowser, do you like fried eggs?
Bet I do. You
I love fried eggs. Love them. But what a weird question. What do you ask? I mean, Bowser seems like the kind of person who likes any kind of food, if you know what I mean.
Well, during my Mario weekend, I stopped at a lovely place called Petal Meadows. I was planning on taking everyone there for a picnic, having some eggs and toast. Of course, I wouldn't think of sending out invitations without asking you first, Lord Bowser.
Airhead! A picnic, you moron! This is no time for fun. See, this is why my evil plans always derail, because you clods always goof off. Ugh!
Oh dear, Lord Bowser, please calm down. Remember your blood pressure.
He's not the old one.
Huh? What's that?
Mumble.
What? Is this true? Lord Bowser, terrible news. Some bald fool
abducted Princess Peach in Rogueport.
Huh? What?
Tell me you're lying, Cammy. How? When? Where? Who'd do such a thing besides me?
I'm afraid we don't have that information quite yet. The investigation's ongoing. One thing is most certainly confirmed, however. The princess has been kidnapped.
She is gone, this is true. Under no circumstances is anyone allowed to kidnap her without my say-so. I will not stand for this. I'm going to Rogueport now. I've got to kidnap her back. It's like that unhealthy boyfriend every time. I have to have her back. She's mine. I have to have her. I don't care what she wants. I have to have her. But your grunginess, wait up. I will get her back no matter what. Stupid. Let's be fair. If she's going to be enough of a jerk to you, even though Bowser's the one in the wrong, if she's going to be enough to jerk to you, like, just don't. Just don't.
Koops, my lad, are you telling me that you're going with Mario?
That's right, Dad. I'm going to continue traveling with Mario. And then I'm going to come back strong Koopa like you, Dad.
Nicely said, young Koops. That's my boy. But always remember this, you are my son, Koops, and I am your father.
Wow! Thank you, Captain Obvious. Koops, my sweet, I'll be right here waiting for you to prove yourself.
Ouch. May I just add, if anything happens, you can always come home, Koops. Don't you ever forget that. This village will always be your home.
Oh, thank you, everyone. Well, I'm off.
The toe in the background, like, I'm not supposed to be a part of this.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mario. You know, farewells. So, where are we going?
Let's head back to Rogueport. Remember, Mario? The bearer of the magical map shall unfurl it before the thousand-year door. When this is done, the stars shall guide the bearer to the crystal star with pure light.
And it didn't stop there. Each crystal star shall point you to the next. That's what the book says.
Which means if we take the crystal star we found back to the thousand-year door, so that means the location of the next crystal star will appear on that magic map.
Exactly. Come on, let's go.
Someone who's not an idiot, finally.
God, Goombella annoys me so much. But she's my only one of my two party members, so I have to appreciate her, I guess. But we're going to call this episode here. I know this one's going to be a little longer because of all that backstory after Hooktail, but it's kind of what gives this game its charm, so just going to have to bear with it for now. Thank you all so much for watching. Please subscribe to see more of this. Don't forget to hit the bell icon so you know I upload videos. Leave a comment if I missed something or you want to see something different. Again, thank you all so much for watching. I will see you all in the next video that I record. Alright? Peace.